Hello, my beautiful YouTube and internet friends. Welcome to my channel. In today's video, you can see how you can make a low budget mask and how to use it to make an art journal page. My channel is all about showing you how you can do your art journaling, mixed media and crafting on a low budget. My name is Ilona, better known on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram and WordPress as Picture for Life. On my channel, you will find a lot of easy and free tutorial videos for art journaling and mixed media, as well as a lot of tips and tricks to do your art journaling, mixed media and crafting on a low budget. I'm all about keeping it simple, even if it looks difficult. Trust me, it's not. So if you like to see more low budget, mixed media and art journaling, subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon so you know when I upload a new video. As a base, I used a page out of a street map book. And for the mask, I used a low budget way by cutting out people of some free advertising brochures for clothing. This paper is pretty sturdy and I can use it multiple times. If you want to reuse it over and over, then I also have a great tip for you. You can use clear packaging tape on the front and on the back and tape it over your mask and then cut it out, and that way you can use this dye mask that you made yourself multiple times. You could even, if you do it very carefully, wash it off. And I used two different masks in this case, a bigger one and a smaller one, and I really put them in distance of each other. I placed the dye mask on the page and I take a makeup sponge to dab my favorite color of paint onto my page. I used very, very little paint and applied it really thin so I can still see the map background shining through, because that was really what I wanted. The next step, I really need to make these masks pop, because otherwise you could not even see they were figures. So I'm taking my Stabilo All pencil in black. You could also use a normal coloring pencil in black, or a charcoal pencil, or even a little paintbrush and some black paint or some black ink. This is just to make sure it will pop off the page. I'm smooching it out with my finger and a little bit of water, and you instantly see that makes a pretty big difference. So that's what I'm doing all around both of my masks. I wanted to add a layer of stamping, and I ink up my stamp and I see I only have one of my masks on, and my stamp is pretty big, so I need a second mask as well, which is a little fiddly because I need to get them down on the right spot both at the same time so I can stamp over it. That way it looks like my stamping is in the background. So I try that again, keeping my masks in place and stamping. So I have to do that several times, and as soon as I get my stamp up, the masks will stick to my stamp, so I can do it all over again. I could have used some tape or something sticky to stick them down, but didn't have that around. So this works as well, it just takes a little bit more effort. So when my stamping is done, I'm going for another layer, and this time I'm using a stencil and some wool filler. I say it a lot, but that's what I use when I stencil most of the time. Just cheap wool filler, and it works fine. The thing with this wool filler is it's kind of porous, because when I go over it with ink or color, any kind of color, it soaks it up. So you can tint it beforehand, but also afterwards. So when I'm done with that layer, I'm drying it completely. Because I wanted to use my mask again, I thought it would be handy if I do it really careful and not smear all the wall filler over the mask, so I try to keep it away from my masks, and that way I cannot do it all at once, so that's why I'm drying it in between, so the layer is dry and I can put my second mask in place and do the same thing there. That way my stenciling will also look like it's been in the bag. So I want my masked persons to be completely clean of background color or stamping or stenciling in this case. So the second layer is being dried again, and then I'm adding again my black pencil, because, and I do it thicker this time because I didn't thought it was giving enough shadows, and I also add some water to really make it black, and then I'm also smearing it out a little bit with my finger so the shadows will be standing out a little bit more. I think this page is actually one of the easiest pages I ever made, but it reflects how I feel sort of invisible during this whole corona crisis situation. People don't really look at you anymore, and if they do, it's more like they are afraid of you or trying to keep away from you, keeping the distance. So that's kind of the feeling that I wanted to emphasize in this page. And when I'm done with my basic background, I also journal about that on my page. I don't know about you, but I notice there's a lot of fear around me. I am not particularly fearful myself about the situation. And we may still go outside to get groceries or for a walk or ride our bikes when we do keep our distance from others and avoid areas where it's too busy. But yesterday we went for a bike ride to get our exercise, and we bought some ice cream because the weather was so nice. Blue skies and sunny, no clouds to see at all. We sat on a bench to enjoy our ice cream, definitely keeping our distance from other people. There was one man who sat on a bench all the way at the corner of the bench, and he looked kind of frightened, keeping an eye on us if we did not come too close. So people seem to be afraid of any connection or closeness. And I really get that, but it really hit me at the same time. And I felt so disconnected and lonely sitting there with all the distance between that old man. And I asked him how he was doing, and he reacted, "Why? Do I look sick?" And I replied, "No, you look fine. I just was wondering how you are doing, and I hoped you are not lonely." So we got in this conversation together, and it made me realize that connection is so important to us, and how easy it is in this whole situation to get lonely and forget all about other people, keeping distance and feeling disconnected from each other. And it felt so good just have this little conversation with somebody I didn't even know. Just to let them know, hey, I see you. Even during this horrible time where we have to keep our distance, I do see you. So that's just a little thing that stood out that day for me. I really wanted to get these feelings onto a piece of paper, because I think when we look back and this corona thing is all over, we probably realized this is a really big thing in our history, so it needs to be documented into my art journal. So that is what this page is all about. So back to the page. I also create a black border around my page. Didn't like that much. So I had this new sort of a paint pen. It's called a glitter marker, and I'm making a border with that. I also added along the border on the inside of my mask, just bring in a bit of extra color. It is a green, teal green color with a lot of glitter in there. So then I have this word I made on my computer, white letters in a black box, and it says invisible. If you like some more detailed information on this technique, then you can find a link that I will add with a video tutorial. You can find it in the description box below the video, along with a lot of more links where you can find more inspiration on several different subjects. You can also click on the little white circle at the top of your screen. It will fold out a menu with even more links to click on. In that particular person I journal, I feel invisible. And then in the bigger person, I am journaling my feelings about missing connection and feeling distant and lonely. So it's all about the feelings that I described earlier in this video. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed my video, and thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful and creative day. And I hope to see you back next Thursday for a new free tutorial video. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so you will be notified when my new video is up.